Hey guys, it's Larry Greenberg, and today we're going to take a look at the Spigen SGP Linear Clockwork Series case for the iPhone 4 and 4S. This sells for $27.99, and it comes in two color variations. You can choose from the champagne and gold version or the infinity white version. So let's crack open this packaging and find out what the Clockwork Series case is all about. If you know me, you'll know that the Linear Series case is one of my favorite all-time cases, out of all the iPhone cases I reviewed, not just from SGP. And it's great that they're making like a bunch of different variations of this case. So inside here, you do get a bunch of stuff. You'll find a crystal clear screen shield, and you guys know SGP makes some of the best screen shields around. You get a cleaning cloth, little certificate of authenticity, and an Apple logo protector. Pretty cool they give you all this stuff. I'm telling you, SGP does not skimp when it comes to add-ons. And then the case itself. So let me get all this stuff out of the way. Essentially, if you haven't seen the Linear case before, it consists of a back plate and a frame. And what makes this so kind of cool is all this stuff is interchangeable. Not that you'd necessarily want to interchange the pieces of the Clockwork case, but look for some reviews coming up that kind of showcase how all the different pieces of the Linear series can be interchanged. Now, the Clockwork case features a really unique backplate in that it's printed on both sides. So hopefully you guys can make out there's a design on one side, and then there's also a design printed on the other side as well. Super cool. Now I happen to think that the white one looks, or the white version I guess I should say, looks better on a black phone. So I do have my dummy black iPhone here. I'll show it to you on my white 4S as well. I just don't think it looks as good, but who knows, you may like it. So how I do it is I stick the backplate on like so, and then I take the top frame and kind of like align it all together like so, and then take the bottom piece and snap it on. Now there's one right way for the bottom piece to go on, so you kind of have to make sure that all your grooves are lined up, and then it all clicks in place like so. So there's the white. You can see you just can't really make out the Clockwork image as well. The champagne and gold version, which they do show on a white phone, you can make it out a little bit more. But to me, it looks kind of like the back plate is broken on my phone, which you may like. It's still kind of subtle this way. So I'm gonna pop this off and put it on the black phone just so you can see. I've often actually gotten questions about how to remove the Linear series from your phone. It's really quite easy. You just pop one of the sides off, and then the whole frame comes apart. So you just kind of gotta gain a leverage point on one of the sides and then just pop, and you can see the whole frame comes right off. So let me remove it from my white phone and bring in the black phone, because I think it really works well on the black phone. Really looks cool. And let's put it on. Same process. I'm gonna line it up, put the bottom piece on. Remember, it only goes on one way, and then kind of snap it together. Let's see, do I have it on the right way? I do. And like so. There we go. So you can see, I think it looks a lot better with the black version of the iPhone 4 or 4S personally. Let's take a look at all the ports and controls and everything. On the bottom, there are individual cutouts for the 30-pin connector, the speaker, and the main mic. You can dock this with most docks. It's pretty wide open and it's not too thick at the bottom. On the side here, you have the Linear logo embossed there, and then one generous cutout there for the volume buttons and the vibrate switch, of course making this able to work with all the versions of the 4 and the 4S. Across the top, a somewhat narrow headset jack. You may have issues with larger headsets. And then a small cutout for the secondary mic, and a large cutout as well for the sleep awake. There's the view of the back with a pill-shaped cutout that's lined with a black liner to prevent flashback for the flash and camera. And again, this Clockwork image looks awesome on the black phone. You kind of can see the screws and the gears and all the different things. I just think you can really make it out more. Now, the reason it's printed on both sides is it almost makes it look three-dimensional. It's kind of hard to make out, but you can kind of see how, you know, pieces are in front and behind of each other, especially like around where the screws are, which make it look almost 3D. Now, you don't get much in the way of lay on the table with this, but that does mean that it'll work with virtually any screen protector. Again, if you know me, you know I think lay on the table is sort of overrated. If you've got a screen protector on, you know, that's enough for me. And all the other, obviously, ports and controls are totally accessible and totally fine. So the Linear case is one of, again, my most favorite cases of all time for the iPhone. And I love that they're coming out with all these different versions. I'll have some more versions of the Linear case coming up on the channel soon. So make sure you're subscribed so you can keep up to date when those reviews are posted. I will put a link in the video description where you can learn more about the Spigen SGP Linear Clockwork Series case. As always, if you have any questions about it, you know you can drop me a line. Otherwise, have a great day. Please be sure to check out my two latest videos. Please like this video, leave a comment below, and of course, subscribe for more content.